Hello friends, welcome to this video on circles. In the previous video, we learned that the sum of each pair of opposite angles in a cyclic quadrilateral is 180 degrees. Today we will discuss the converse of this theorem. Friends, now if it is said that the sum of a pair of opposite angles of a quadrilateral is 180 degrees, then it is a cyclic quadrilateral. Will this statement be correct? Let's see. According to the statement, we will draw a quadrilateral PQRS in which the sum of a pair of opposite angles is 180 degrees. That is, we can say that the sum of angle PQR and angle PSR is 180 degrees. So will PQRS be a cyclic quadrilateral? Come, let's see. Friends, we know that we can draw one circle passing through three non-collinear points. We make a similar construction here, drawing a circle that passes through the points P, Q and R. Now, if we prove that point S is also located on this circle, then we can say that PQRS is a cyclic quadrilateral. So let's assume that point S is not located on the circle. Then line segment PS will intersect the circle at some point. Suppose it will intersect it at point T. Friends, it is also possible that the point S lies in the interior of the circle. In this case, the figure will look something like this. Look at the first situation. Now the four points P, Q, R and T are located on the circle. Thus, quadrilateral PQRT will be a cyclic quadrilateral. We know that the sum of each pair of opposite angles of the cyclic quadrilateral is 180 degrees. In this way, we will get these two equations. And the sum of the angle PQR and angle PSR is given as 180 degrees. We assume this as equation 3. Now observe the equations 2 and 3 carefully. In this, angle PQR is common. That is, angle PTR and angle PSR are equal. Now observe triangle TSR. Angle PTR is its external angle, which will be equal to the sum of angles TSR and TRS. We can also call angle TSR as angle PSR. And we can see in equation 4 that angle PSR and angle PTR are equal. Therefore, we get that the value of angle TRS is 0. Friends, this is possible only when the points T and S are coincident. That is, they both are the same point. Thus, the point S is located on the circle itself. Therefore, our statement is false. So we can say that PQRS is a cyclic quadrilateral. In this way, we proved this theorem. You can repeat the same process for the second case and verify this statement. That is it for this session. Today we have proved that if the sum of a pair of opposite angles in a quadrilateral is 180 degrees, that quadrilateral is cyclic. See you in the next video with some questions based on this. Thank you.